Hello everyone, my name is Sylwia Vargas and I will tell you how I added a real-time feature to my Next.js app. So here is my app for making and sharing polls. It has just two pages. The first page lets you create a poll and the second one features the poll that you just created. And now you can share it with all your friends. Now I want to see the votes as they come in real time. It's gonna look like this. The idea came from three places. First, a web component created by MatWeb that allows you to add a real-time poll to any page. Second, there was Daniel Rowe who used a live poll to gauge audience knowledge of Next during a conference. And then finally, Chris Early built an awesome app that lets you vote for cats. In fact, you can try my app right now and vote whether you think my demo will work. I think it will. It's a pre-recorded talk. But let's talk about why bother with real time. It is so important to build websites that are fast, and Next.js is perfect for that. Thanks to Next.js and React Server components, it has never been easier to build websites that are fast, especially paired with Vercel's Edge network. We can confidently guarantee that our users will have fast experiences because the rendering happens in an edge location near them. But we want more. We want the website to feel fast and be reactive throughout the user session. When a user does something on the website, we want these changes to be available to other users immediately without refreshing. There is this well-known technology that allows you to push data to your users while they are on the page. It's called websockets. However, Next.js is a serverless framework, and unfortunately, websockets require you to run a server. That's a lot of work to build, scale, and maintain. Enter PartyKit. PartyKit makes it very easy to push data to users through websockets without running your own servers. Think about it this way. Next.js simplifies rendering websites. PartyKit simplifies building with websockets. Both run on the same edge network, so they are fast together. Just like with Next.js, with PartyKit, you don't have to worry about hosting. You can just write code. Here's the code for a simple PartyKit room. This is all you need to make your app real time. When you're ready to go live, PartyKit will deploy it to hundreds of edge locations across the globe. Okay, let's build. This will be a technical talk where I will write quite a lot of code. So we will create a WebSocket server with custom logic that will run on PartyKit. Then we will connect it to our existing Next.js app using web standards protocols like HTTP and WebSockets. And then finally, we'll deploy the server. Are you ready? Let's go. First, let's add PartyKit. Run npm PartyKit init. And done. What this command did is added three things. First, PartyKit package, which enables building and deploying real-time servers. Second, PartySocket package, which provides a WebSocket client that will automatically reconnect if connection is lost. And third, a new directory where our server code will live. So now let's run the dev server on our local machine. And now the fun begins. We'll now set up the server for creating new polls. Let's open the server template that was created for us. And since each poll will have its own room, we can keep our poll data in memory. We can also use the TypeScript types from our Next.js app. We want to create the poll from a Next.js server component. Let's define a handler for receiving HTTP requests. When the app sends the poll information to the server, we can read from the request and store it in our class field. In real life, you'd want to validate it, but we'll skip that for now and just trust TypeScript. Also return the poll data that we already have so we can render it later. When the user submits the poll form, let's have the Next.js app send it to our PartyKit server. So let's find the file that generates the form. And we've already written the code to get the data from the form in our server action. Thanks, Next.js. So all we need to do right now is to send it to PartyKit. We can make your old HTTP request to the server. Please notice the ID. Every new ID gets you a new server. So every poll will have its own cozy PartyKit room. Oh my God, it works. But look, the data is static, so it's kind of faking. So let's change that. We'll now connect the poll page. So let's move to the Next.js server component that renders the poll. As you remember, our PartyKit server returns the poll data in the onRequest method. You can use it to render the poll on the server. You might have noticed the revalidate zero. Next.js will cache server fetches by default. We want to always have up-to-date votes, so we can disable caching. Because PartyKit runs on the same network as Vercel, this will be fast. And as I said, we started with static poll data. So let's read the response from the server and replace the mock data. And now our app is working. So far, we talked a lot about WebSockets, but we haven't actually used them yet. The PartyKit server is ready and waiting for WebSockets, so let's connect them. Let's go to the component that renders the poll. Please note that this is not a server component, so the connection will happen on the user's device. We could use the standard WebSocket constructor here, but PartyKit comes with a React hook, so we're going to use that. We provide the same poll ID, which we created a moment ago, so WebSocket will connect to the right poll. Now, we need to tell PartyKit what to do when we receive a message from the server. In this case, we want to update the votes. We can parse the message from the server and update the local component state. And the UI will update automatically. Thanks, React. Finally, let's make it possible to vote. All we need to do is send a vote message to the server when the user clicks the option. Our PartyKit server receives the message but doesn't know what to do with them. So let's fix that with a single method. Back to the server file. Our users vote by sending WebSocket messages, so let's add an onMessage handler. Then let's parse the incoming message and increment the vote for that option and broadcast the updated poll to all clients so they see votes come in live. It's literally just one line of code. Now we can deploy. And look, this is our app. It's working. So in this QR code, you can see the demo. You can explore the code, but also as a bonus, there's a tutorial that includes production features like authentication, database, and so much more. So thank you for listening, and let's be friends, because everything is better with friends.